She's never afraid. Just picture everybody naked. She really doesn't like to wait. Too far, I know we'd be alright. I know we would be alright if you were by my side. And we stumbled in the dark, I know we'd be alright. I know we would be alright. Cause if we lost our minds and we took it way too far, I know we'd be alright. I know we would be alright if you were by my side. We stumbled in the dark, I know we'd be alright. We would be alright. Oh, I've been shaking. Crazy, you take all my inhibitions. Baby, there's nothing holding me back. You take me places that tear up my reputation, manipulate my decisions. Baby, there's nothing holding me back.
Small town blue. This place seems so small to me. But I was used to the boulevard. When I saw you, I felt so hard. Now I never wanna leave. Girl, I'm here forever. We got moonlight all night. Lord, I pray on the next star. You have told me a few years back that I'd be still in here at this place I'm at. I'd say you're living in a dream. I could stay here forever. We got moonlight all night. Lord, I pray on the next star I see tonight. We never lose this thing found. A year by my side, I can do without the city light. I fly so high. Touch your ground.
You say you'll be down in 5. The smell of your perfume is floating down the stairs. You're fixing up your hair like you do.
I know that I'll be a mess the second that I see you. You won't be surprised, it happens every time, it's nothing new.
It's always on a night like tonight. I thank God you can read my mind.
Cause when you look at me with those eyes,
I'm speechless, staring at you standing there in that dress. What it's doing to me ain't a secret. Cause watching you is all that I can do. And I'm speechless. You already know that you're my weakness. After all this time I'm just as nervous. Every time you walk into the room, I'm speechless.
It started when you said hello. Just did something to me. And I've been in a daze ever since the day that we met.
You took the breath out of my lungs, can't even fight it. And all of the words out of my mouth without even trying. And I'm speechless, staring at you standing there in that dress. What it's doing to me ain't a secret. Cause watching you is all that I can do. And I'm speechless. You already know that you're my weakness. After all this time I'm just as nervous. Every time you walk into the room, I'm speechless. Let me pray for us real quick as we open. Father in heaven, we come to you at this special time asking for your guiding hand to rest on Fernie and Braeli as they commit their lives together in this ceremony. We want to honor you in these moments and we ask your spirit to fill them during this ceremony. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. 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 You got to see.
gives this woman to be buried?
Her mother and I.
Love you.
I'll take care of her.
All right. How are you feeling? You okay?
Yeah, I'm good.
Y'all are going to do great. This is going to be great. Hey, I just wanted to say we're so grateful to be a part of this day. This is an amazing time. Everything's going to go super smooth. Everything's going to be great. We're going to give some vows. We're going to do some rings. So just take a minute. Take it all in. I just encourage you, don't lose out on this time right here. This is a special time. We stand here before God because marriage is one of His most beautiful creations. He designed man and woman in His image, and He created the institution of marriage. Therefore, it is good. It is sacred, and it is holy. This is a celebration of the love and commitment that you guys have as you start this new life together. The vows you say in a few minutes will join you together in one of life's holiest bonds. But before we get to that, I want to look at what Jesus has to say about marriage. In Matthew chapter 19, Jesus says that in the beginning, the Creator made them male and female, and said, for this reason, a man will leave his father and his mother and be united to his wife. And the two will become one flesh. So they are no longer two, but one flesh. Together, what God has joined, let no one separate. So we see right here that God loves us and He has created us to love others. Our lives find completion only as we love and we are loved in return. And together we can be more than we could ever be separately. And the second thing is, this ceremony of marriage where you come to be united right now is the first and oldest ceremony in all the world. Celebrated in the beginning in the presence of God Himself. Marriage is a gift of God, given to comfort the sorrows of this life and magnify its joys. So now is the time for you both to express your vows of love and devotion for each other. So Fernie, you volunteered to go first, and I've got a microphone for you right here. And you're going to kick us off, man. So it's going to be good.
All right. Whew. Bray. I vow to put you and our family first. It's important to know that times will get tough and problems will come, but I vow to hit those problems with you head on. I vow to stand by you no matter how big, how scary, and how long a problem persists. I vow to keep bettering myself by learning and working hard for the rest of our lives. I vow to make sure you feel safe and secure at all times, to keep you out of harm's way, even if you think I'm doing too much. I vow to always be honest and communicate my feelings, even though I'm not really good at communication or feelings.
Working on it.
I vow to always pay attention to detail when it comes to you, to keep loving you for who you are, and I vow to always give you unconditional love that you deserve. I love you, Bebre.
Okay. There you go. You'll have the microphone. Your turn.
Fernie, is it on?
Yeah.
Okay. My first love, you are everything I've hoped for and nothing I expected. I truly could not have asked for a better person to get to do life with. I get butterflies thinking about our future adventures together. Thank you for making me laugh every single day, and thank you for pushing me out of my comfort zone no matter how much I hate it. Because of you, I'm a better person. We are both far from perfect, and life will be hard. So with that being said, I vow to never go to bed angry. I vow to be your comforter, ready with back scratches. I vow to never stop hanging out and eating food with you. I vow to always support you in your dreams, whether that is becoming a paleontologist or slowly racing your dirt bike into your 50s or attempting to get on the PGA Tour. I cannot wait to continue to fall in love with you as my husband. I love you most today and forever.
I love you too. Through these marriage vows, you will make a commitment together to face your disappointments, embrace your dreams, realize your hopes, accept each other's failures. So as we continue, your best man and I have a question for the both of you, and I'll take that microphone from you. I'll give it over to you. Starting with you, Fernie.
Woo.
Fernie, do you take Braeli to be your wife?
Hello.
To have and to hold from this day forward? For better or for worse? For richer or for poorer? In sickness and in health? To love and to cherish? Until you are parted by death.
I do.
And Braeli, do you take Fernie to be your husband?
Braeli, ¿cómo estás tratando como tu esposo?
To have and to hold from this day forward?
Para tener y sostener de ahora en adelante.
For better or for worse?
En las buenas y en las malas.
For richer or for poorer?
En la riqueza y la pobreza.
In sickness and in health?
En la enfermedad y salud.
To love and to cherish.
Para amar y adorar.
Until you are parted by death.
I do.
The Word of God describes the kind of love that we are to have for each other in 1 Corinthians 13. It says, love is patient, love is kind. It does not envy and it does not boast. It is not proud, it does not dishonor others. It is not self-seeking, it is not easily angered. It keeps no record of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil but rejoices in the truth. It always protects, always trusts, always hopes, always perseveres. Love never fails. So having this kind of love in your hearts, you've chosen to seal these vows by the giving and receiving of rings. So may I see the rings that you have for each other?
It's in your pocket, it's in your pocket.
Yeah, in there. Beautiful boxes too. All of these rings are small in size, they are huge in significance. They are made of precious metal. It reminds us that love is not common or cheap, and it may indeed cost us dearly, and it is beautiful to witness. So Fernie, will you take the ring you have for Braeli and place it on the third finger of her left hand? And repeat this promise. With this ring, I seal my promise. To be your faithful and loving husband.
As God is my witness.
And Braeli, take the ring you have for Fernie and place it on that same finger and repeat after me. With this ring. I seal my promise. To be your faithful and loving wife. As God is my witness. And as you wear these rings, whether you're together or apart, may they be constant reminders of the promises and the vows that you've made here today. Let's pray. Father, we come today asking for your blessing on these two lives and this home that is being established. I pray that your love will be the shield and stay for Fernie and Braeli as they start this life together. Give them patience, gentleness, understanding, and abundance of love. May they ever seek after you, and through that be drawn closer together. Thank you for the love that we witness here today. And may that love continue to grow throughout their lives here together. Amen.
Amen.
So you have expressed your vows of love for each other, and you've sealed those vows by the giving and receiving of rings. So therefore, by virtue of the authority vested in me as the minister of the gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ, in accordance to the laws of God in the state of Texas, I now pronounce you husband and wife. Fernie Kister.
your love away, I hate myself. I'm gonna tell you lies so your heart won't break. Yeah, I know that I made my fair share of mistakes. Sometimes I don't know why you love me.
First off, we have Sam and Nicholas. This is your four.
Now in Spanish. Gracias a todos por venir. Significa mucho que hayan venido. Tomás, el día tan especial para mí y Braeli. Eso. Gracias y party on, baby. Woo! Break up and eat, baby. Let's go.
That's right. Everybody gets your guns up. Ladies and gentlemen, it is with great pleasure to introduce you again to the special Urbina. Come on, get your guns up.
Más aquí estoy. Frágil te ves, dulce y sensual. Quiero abrazarte y te protegeré. Esta fusión es irrompible. No llores más, aquí estoy. Desde hoy será y para siempre.
siempre amor. En mi corazón, no importa qué dirán, dentro de mí estarás siempre. No pueden entender nuestro sentir, ni confiarán en nuestro proceder. Sé que hay diferencias, mas por dentro somos iguales tú y yo. En mi corazón tú vivirás.
Thank you.
realize you're happy, how much your love has grown. And I'll kiss you on the forehead and say, hey, baby, what's wrong? You'll say nothing, I just love you, 'cause you never made me wonder. You're the one I want.
Mother-in-law. So where is Fernie's mother-in-law? Come on out here. Come on out here and dance with your son-in-law. Hey, Fernie. I'm sorry, man. I messed up and I forgot to download the song. I screwed up. I'm sorry. Do you just want me to pick something? Is that all right with you? Okay, I'll just pick something. Okay, all right.
One, two, three, My baby don't mess around, because she loves me so, and this I know for sure. But does she really wanna, but can't stand to see me walk out the door? Don't try to fight the feeling, 'cause the thought alone is killing me right now. Thank God for mom and dad for sticking two together, 'cause we don't know how.
Touching me. got the whole stadium in love like it.
Good evening. My name is Humberto Olivas. I'm the best man. Cousin of the great Ferndog Urbina. And now cousin of Braeli Urbina. So, I'm just going to keep it real nice and sweet. And allow Corinne to do her thing right now. But, I just want to say that I'm extremely proud of Fernando and Braeli. Super excited to be celebrating this day with them. So thankful that they allowed me to be a part of their wedding in such an intimate manner, to kind of be there at his right hand, be his right hand man throughout this whole process. It's been a lot of fun. So thank you both for allowing me to be a part of this. So. You guys are extremely important to my wife and myself, my family back home who didn't get a chance to make it tonight. I miss them dearly. But, you know, Braeli, it's been a pleasure knowing you these few years that we've gotten to know each other. I couldn't have asked for a better ride for my cousin. You're such a sweet woman. You're kind, you're noble, you're all the good things that we look for in our partner, so I know he's gonna be in good hands. But I don't know about you. This, you gotta deal with this guy for the rest of your life. So. And he's quite a handful. I mean, I know I've known him his whole life, and I'm looking at the pictures out here, and it reminds me of all the times we've been through. We've been through some real low lows, him and I, and I'm just so grateful to be at his highest moment, standing at his right hand side, so you know what I'm talking about, cuz I love you, man. And I'm proud to be here to guide you and whatever you need. Advice, you know we're here. So, I mean, I could say a lot of things about you, but I guess the most telling thing that I could say about Fernie is the kind of person he is. My wife and I recently had a daughter. And she's about a month old, and as you know, the whole process and her being born, you know, if you're a father of a woman, a girl, you know exactly what I'm talking about. Their whole lives flash before your lives, and their whole lives flash before your eyes. And when you get to that part where you're wondering what kind of man she's going to meet, what kind of person she's gonna spend the rest of her life with. I'm hoping he's not like me. I'm hoping it's like that guy right there. Because he's just a great guy. He's been a great partner to Braeli. He loves her, I know that for sure. He's loyal to her. He's all the good things that we should be to our wife. So congratulations to you both. I'm so happy for you guys. And I wanna go ahead and start with a toast. As we do in our culture, our hometown. You guys just follow me and we'll get through this. So, pa' arriba, pa' abajo, pa' centro, pa' dentro. Nice and safe. Wish you guys the best in the rest of your life.
Next we have Corinne, the bride, sister, and maid of honor, who's gonna give the next toast.
Is a built-in best friend. However, that doesn't mean those best friends always get along. It is no secret that I liked you way more than you liked me in the beginning. Growing up with you, I remember being the doll, maid, stunt double, and sometimes even a step stool when playing with you.
Though those roles aren't what you dream of as a little sister, I wouldn't trade that for anything because I was getting attention from the coolest person I knew. Flash forward to Nicholas being born. Our love for one another grew as our younger brother got all the benefits of being the youngest child.
Mom may say we're all her favorites, but we know who takes that place. Now we are inseparable. You are my best friend and hold a piece of my heart. You are my biggest role model. You are my biggest role model, and I will always turn to you for advice. I am truly blessed with the best sister. Fernie, you are the older brother I've always wanted but never had, and you fill that place perfectly. You love me wholeheartedly and show me the importance of respect. I am so happy that Bray found that type of happiness in such an incredible person. Thank you for putting up with my not-so-kind older sister. And thank you for loving my family. You both deserve all the smiles the world can give. I love you both, and congratulations.
Yeah. Who would like to come out here and say a couple words? So come on out here.
Alright, Patti. I'm probably gonna cry. Patti. RT, you got a recording? All right.
Got it, Jason!
Welcome, family and friends, to the celebration of the marriage of Braeli and Fernando. Okay, forgive me on this. Bienvenidos, familias y amigos, a la celebración del matrimonio de Braeli y Fernando. That's all I got. So, if you don't know me, I'm Jason. Braeli is my daughter. I hope to get through this with little tears, but I cannot promise all of that. So, here we go. Holly and I were 23 when Braeli was born, and today you're 23. In the legendary. Right. She's the oldest of our three children, and we experienced all of our firsts with Braeli. First dirty diaper, oh my God. First steps, preschool. First temper tantrum, remember that?
Oh yeah.
Yep. Body by God, inside joke for those that were there when I called. Amanda, you were there, chicken. Driving, dropping off at college, and now marriage. And all those firsts were amazing, scary, sometimes embarrassing. But most importantly, Braeli made me a father for the first time. She was a great first kid, a couple of 23-year-olds that had no idea of what to do. I'm not even sure we had a savings account when she was born. We truly were flying by the seat of our pants. She hardly ever cried. She loved her plug-plug, aka pacifier, her Johnny Jump, and she slept all night the first night she was home. She loves to nap, and even put herself to bed when she had sleepovers, leaving her friends to wonder what to do, and to this day, still loves to take naps. Braeli was also very mature for her age. She just seemed to be older than her age. This almost backfired on me when she was around 10. I needed to back the car out of the garage, and I thought to myself, I'll let Braeli do it. Now,
you might be thinking, oh, that's not so bad. She probably was just going to sit on my lap and control the steering wheel. No. I put her in the driver's seat and stayed out on the outside of the car, gave her clear instructions, so I thought. And Braeli proceeded to get the pedals confused. Slamming on the gas, peeling out of the garage, heading straight towards our neighbor's house. Luckily for me, she found the brake pedal as I was jumping into the car window and stopped the car. The look from Holly still gives me the willies. Braeli loved being the oldest sibling, and she still likes throwing the oldest card out from time to time. It doesn't work as much as it did when they were younger, as I think Corinne and Nicholas realized they don't have to do everything Braeli asks. She protected her sister and brother, telling one of her childhood friends to put her sister down as she is her sister. The love they have for each other is like nothing else and is what I'm most thankful for. I think this practice of telling her brother and sister what they needed to be doing has helped her in her being a coach. She expected them to listen and do what she commanded and expects the same from her gym kids. Although Coach Tina may have had a little bit of that as well. In the early days of Braeli and Fernie's relationship, I think how Fernie engaged and reacted with her sister and brother was sort of a test. This was not a problem, as Fernie is a kid at heart. And he loves Jurassic Park almost as much as Nicholas. And can entertain Corinne until she tires out, which is not an easy feat. By engaging with her siblings, Fernie not only won over Braeli, he got bonus points with Holly. As parents, you make decisions in your kids' lives, and at that moment, you don't know what the outcome of those decisions might someday lead to. Take gymnastics. Braeli has been doing gymnastics since Holly took her at 3 years old to Mommy and Me class, where she was introduced to tumbling. Braeli did gymnastics until her senior year in high school, where she then started cheering gymnastics. Gymnastics led her to getting a job first year at Tech at Tega, where we had several meets when she was younger. How did Holly and I know that taking Braeli to a gym class 20 years ago would lead to her meeting her first boyfriend, who turned into her fiance, and today her husband? We didn't, and now I'm second guessing our decision. Just kidding. Honestly, we didn't know, and the only solution is that it was fate and that God had a plan for her and Fernie. In Jeremiah 29:11, God states, "For I know the plans I have for you, plans for welfare and not for evil, to give you a future and a hope." I do believe that is a true, and the motions that were set all those years ago was a plan laid out by God. That is what makes this day such a special occasion. Braeli, it's been fun watching you grow up. You are confident and strong. That knows what you want, and you are not afraid to go get it. I'm so very proud of you. And although you are no longer a little girl, in my heart, you will always be that sweet little girl that clutched onto my finger the first moments I held you. Fernando and Patti, you guys raised a great kid. And I feel blessed to be able to call Fernie my son-in-law. The second or third time I met Fernie, I hired an enforcer to help me lay down the law. You know, a real tough guy, in order for him to know whose daughter he was trying to date. That enforcer was a childhood friend of mine, Jared, and unfortunately, he was not able to make it, but I'm going to tell him I want my money back. It was a strange intervention that had Jared taking his shirt off, and well, I'll let Jared tell you that story one day. But the point is, I was a real asshole that night. night and ended up apologizing to Fernie for both Jared and I's behavior the next morning. Fernie said to me, I would have done the same thing and that he understood. Now, he doesn't have a daughter, so he could not have grasped what I was going through. But that is when I knew I wasn't dealing with some guy that was going to be gone in a couple of weeks and break my daughter's heart. I was looking at me when I was chasing my head, determined to not let anything get in the way for being with her. Fernie was a real trooper that night, but just remember, Jared is on just a phone call away. Fernie, or Fern Dog, as he's known around the Peters house, is a bit of an extrovert. This outgoing personality is great for my daughter. Braeli is like her mom, but she does have my reserve and needs that persuasion at times. Fernie provides that persuasion that Braeli needs, gets her out to try new things, and I'm thankful for that. Fernie has done nothing but defended her, put her first, and loved her. I could not have envisioned a better person to take Braeli's hand from mine than the Fern Dog. Braeli and Fernie. I lift a glass to you and tell you that this is not always easy. It is not always fun. But as long as you put God first, communicate with each other, and always remember this moment, I promise those hard, not fun days will be outshined with a lifetime of laughs, smiles, and enjoying each other.
Nicely said.
I wish I had a little